doing exactly what you want in that very niche place and being in that environment with people that understand where you're coming from. So I was looking into schools and I looked at Berklee College of Music in Boston, and they offered online courses. So through that I became, after taking those in addition to my grade 11 year in high school, I became a certified music business specialist. So kind of took that, opened up my own record label last year, Django Records, and yeah, trying to keep my, you know, hands in a lot of things, you know.
So there's so much to do. You're a real slacker is like what you're trying to say. Is that it? She's still in high school, has her own record label.
Just finished, actually.
Already took some courses, or just finished, graduated from high school.
This spring.
You're already,
I was accepted have your own to label. Berklee College, but deferring the offer.
Yeah. So I mean, I'm very impressed, but I mean, I'm kind of getting, you know, like, who was it that, when you were younger, that got you interested in wanting to sing? You know, like, there's always, like, some, like, for mm-hmm. me personally, it was like, James Taylor or Dan Fogelberg. When I heard mm-hmm. that kind of music, I wanted to learn how to finger pick and play acoustic and sing guitar, you know, or in the family, we would always gather around the piano because my aunt played the piano and we would sing, like, you know, John Denver tunes or something like that, all right? So, well, was there any particular, you know, artists or somebody that you thought of, you know, like, oh, I'd like to do that, I'd like to, you know, get you interested?
Wow, that's a really hard question. I guess when I was, probably 12 or 13, I went to see Eric Clapton. And I guess before I had this mentality that, you know, if you sang in a band. And, you know, you had great musicians playing with you and you all collaborated and blah, 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 which is a great thing. But I went to see Eric Clapton and there he was. And there were so many songs, like, yes, of course he had a backing band. So many songs he was just stripped down and playing by himself and playing on guitar and singing and really carrying it. And I thought, you know, that was kind of my first exposure to what I guess a solo musician could be. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm a huge Eric Clapton fan, and he's just done so much, and he's so expressive, and he's so, you know, wonderful, and he's just, there's that presence, and it was interesting for me to see at a young age that just, wow, that can happen, that kind of energy can happen from one person. Yeah. Like, that doesn't mean you don't add on to it with other musicians, but it's like, there's that core, and mm-hmm. I really wanted to at least try to be that core at some point. I'm still working towards it, though.
That's interesting that, you know, you brought that up. That particular time frame, age-wise, is very impressionable. That's when I got started in music. That seems to be like you're really, all of a sudden, you know, trying to figure out, like, what interests you,
yeah.
you know, really. Like, and if you're a creative person, there's so many different directions you can go, you know, and that's really cool. Hey, in case you just joined us, you're listening to Acoustic Songs Live from WNJR Studios. We have Elise Simpson in the studio performing for us today. She came from Toronto, Ontario, and I'd like you to ask you to play another song, if you don't mind.
I'd love to.
Okay, what are you going to do for us here?
I would say this is kind of my one blues-ish inspired song, maybe? It has a little bit of that feel. This is about going through change and not knowing what to do with that change, and trying to figure out the change you need to make in yourself in order to see a change in your environment mm-hmm. and everything else. So it's called Pink Motel.
Pink
Motel.
Pink Motel.
Yes.
Thank you.
That's never on my list, I assume. Although I wasn't in very soon. It opens up my mind, interrupts, unpacks. Sometimes I'm lucky enough to have Kira and Chris play on it, and it's really different. It's a really different feel. Lately, I've been playing a lot. This is my Yamaha acoustic, but I've been playing a lot on my. Just bought a 1980 Telecaster.
Oh, okay.
Honey blonde, and it's beautiful. So I have a lot of fun kind of doing it with the different sounds.
Yeah, I can hear that definitely rocking out. electric guitars and drums and bass, that for sure. So tell me a little bit about. You said you're from Toronto, but is that actually in Toronto, or are you from the outside of Toronto, or what's music scene like up there? But I guess people don't normally travel to Toronto to hear. Folks in Toronto, where do you normally play? Like, where people can see you?
Well, I'm just outside of Toronto, about 30 minutes in Oakville. It's just a pretty normal suburb. We're lucky enough, though, in that area to just 10 minutes away from where I live, where I did my first gig, actually, as part of a showcase that Julie Cutler puts on at the Moonshine Cafe. And it's a kind of a neat, not quite a dive bar, but very hippie, you know, black and white checkered floors, you know, real kind of rustic feel, so that's nice. But, you know, I traveled to Toronto a bunch to play into Hamilton. Ashwagandha show coming up in Hamilton on the 27th of November after I'm home from the tour. At the Casbah, and I think that's on King Street. Yeah, I'm pretty sure.